Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 60th episode of Excel. We're live here tonight from the aftermath of ACW Round Zero last Friday night. The fallout will be here tonight. Tonight, our main event television champion, Cloud Strife, will go one-on-one in non-title action against a returning PA. We haven't seen EA's victory. He will be in action tonight, our main event against Cloud Strife. Also a Glamor X action, Reiko Hinomoto, now the number one contender for the Glamor X Championship, will go one-on-one against Cammy. All that and more here tonight on ACW Excel number 60. As we get ready for opening contest here, I am Hakeem Johnson, your ACW commentator, as always, and welcome to another edition here of Excel. Thank you for joining us here tonight on an explosive night. No pun intended there, because I was hyping here. Make sure you're joining us right now, wherever that may be, whether that's on Facebook, Twitter, wherever, all around social media here, the ACW experience, all around us, and also join us with the hashtag ACW Excel. In the conversation we discussed here tonight for Excel 60. Ladies and gentlemen, if you did not watch ACW Ground Zero, you need to do so as soon as possible. Hell, I would advise you to pause the show and then go watch ACW Ground Zero on our Mega Events channel, because it was one of the most dramatic, explosive Mega Events I think we have witnessed in quite some time. We can say that a lot this year, but that one in particular. Guess what happened at the end of Ground Zero throughout this entire newscast, throughout this entire broadcast, because that is something that needs to be addressed. As we get to this opening contest here, that man Kinnikuman went to battle with Choji Akimichi. As you're going to see the steel images here, make sure you get to watch Ground Zero on the Mega Fitness channel with that link down there. Kinnikuman and Choji went to war, but at the end of the day, Choji Akimichi pulled up the win against Kinnikuman with that Choji bomb. And afterwards, got attacked by Kinnikuman, but Kinnikuman will come back and combat himself to take out Choji. And I'm sure that this will not be the last from these two. That was one aspect of what you expected from Ground Zero, but we've got to talk about the ending of Ground Zero. I have witnessed a lot of things in ACW and CAW in general, but what transpired at the end of Ground Zero was one of the most just mysterious and destructive things I've ever seen in my life. And Akuma and Aang, they went to the limit. They battled themselves. They put themselves through that Hell in a Cell. That Hell in a Cell was a demonic structure that consumed those two and what they were all about throughout that entire match. And even though Akuma retained and is still our Excel champion, it's what happened afterwards, where Akuma chokeslammed Aang straight through the ring. And I have no idea where the hell Aang is. Aang was not under the ring. Aang just disappeared. And Haru Glory tried finding out answers, but Akuma disappeared. And then some sort of demonic laughter came about afterwards. I have no idea what the hell's going on here. I have tried to call Aang. Aang's wife Katara has tried to call the ACW offices all throughout this entire period this weekend. We have not been able to get any responses from her. She hasn't gotten any responses back from Aang. And that here's the cover by Kinnikuman 1, 2, and a showrunner from Zabuza. There are rumors that Haru Glory will be showing up here tonight to address that situation as a whole here tonight. So a lot of things to go down from the aftermath of the fallout of Round Zero. To get to this opening contest here, let's just kind of switch gears here for a second. Zabuza versus Kinnikuman to open up ACW Excel 60. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure you also be aware that in about 2 weeks, on Sunday, August 16th, it's going to be New Jersey Call Wrestling and Anime Championship Wrestling working together to give you a show crossover special event. Yeah, I said that's five times fast. I'm giving you that to you. It's going to be called Fighting Spirit Katai Ketsu. We revealed the official full card for it on Ground Zero. So make sure you guys check that mega event out. NJCW and ACW on Sunday, August 16th. It's going to be very fun. It's going to be very interesting how that goes. Cover 1-2, kick out. Speaking of which, Kinnikuman will be teaming up with television champion Cloud Strife, representing ACW, to take on NJCW's Vega and Nightwing. Yes, Nightwing of all people. That'll be Nightwing's first ACW appearance since 2008. he last appeared for ACW or anything ACW related. So it's gonna be a lot of emotions there for Nightwing, I'm sure. Just be on the lookout for that Mega Man as Zabuza with a nice uppercut onto Kinnikuman. Bulldog takes down Kinnikuman, and now Kinnikuman bleeding. I mean, Kinnikuman really has not healed from Ground Zero, so it's very easy to open that wound there, but Zabuza just going to work here. Here's the cover. One, two, kick out for Kinnikuman. Kinnikuman working on here. Kinnikuman with a nice takedown. And Kinnikuman can do you take down Zabuza? Zabuza elbow drop. Zabuza with a nice neck break. Supposed to be a, you know, going back to Ground Zero. You know, Haru Glory had to find out the whereabouts of Aang because Aang and Haru have been longtime friends here in ACW since the very beginning when ACW began in 06. Also, Edward Elric was defeated by Haru Glory in that outstanding match between the two at Ground Zero as well. So Haru Glory, again, is rumored to be here tonight and is rumored to address issues that happened at Ground Zero related to him. And here's the Zabuza clotheslines Kinnikuman down, and Kinnikuman's blood is dripping profusely from the forehead. Kinnikuman coming back here onto Zabuza, clubbing him from behind, and look at that, Zabuza stomps right on the back of the leg here. Zabuza gonna grab Kinnikuman's knee and smashes it on his own. Zabuza gonna go that left leg of Kinnikuman's, stomping right on the back leg. Side headlock there by Zabuza. Oh man, irate there, trying to smear the blood right over Kinnikuman's eyes. And once again, Zabuza going to work on that leg. Zabuza with an Irish flip onto Kinnikuman. Zabuza, nice hip toss there, didn't even really try to put much up into it, but probably feels as confident as you can see right here. Zabuza currently control of this match here. Kinnikuman just being removed 72 hours ago or more from that match with Choji Akimichi, so I'm assuming he's not 100%. Kinnikuman lost that match against Choji, but it was Kinnikuman at the end of that night that was standing tall with Choji. You can bet that feud is not going to be over by a long shot as Zabuza continues to work on Kinnikuman. Face lock here. Snapmare. Chin lock onto Kinnikuman. Zabuza digging his knee onto the back of Kinnikuman here, adding more agony towards Kinnikuman's body. Kinnikuman struggling to find a way to get out of this predicament, but can he find some sort of way? He's going to have to try to power out of it, but again, not 100% here tonight. Kinnikuman trying to break away from this hold here. Zabuza finally lets go. Irish with himself in a point-blank DDT sends Kinnikuman down. And it might be time for some Kenjutsu action. Zabuza is able to hit it. No, Kinnikuman counters it to a push. Oh, runs him over. And then Zabuza smears the blood. Oh my goodness! Clothesline from him, and Kinnikuman's still up! I think Zabuza's surprised. Kinnikuman, sharp knee to the midsection. Kinnikuman! No way! He's got him off! Kinnikuman Buster! Right onto Zabuza! Kinnikuman pulling the Kinnikuman Buster out of nowhere. One, two, it's over! Kinnikuman gets the win! Kinnikuman able to nail the Kinnikuman Buster from an unsuspecting Zabuza. Kinnikuman picks up the winner tonight on Excel 60. A nice rebound for Kinnikuman after what transpired at Ground Zero. The crowd here loving every bit of it. Congratulations. What a Kinnikuman here tonight. Oh, wait a minute. That music. And there he is, Choji! Choji's in the building here. Oh man, the war's gonna continue right here, right now. Here we go. Choji, Kinnikuman, trading punches, one by one. The war, the fight between these two continues to roll on. Folks, we gotta take a commercial break here, but Choji, Kinnikuman, ball all the way backstage here. We need to get some help.
Hi, I'm Adam Jackpot, the owner and ruler of the world of NJCW. Now, I take it you like car wrestling. Not a shocker. I take it you like wrestling, too. And maybe if you're a fan of, like, fantasy and shit, like comic books and movies and all that stuff, you pretty much would enjoy it as well. So I'm here with a pretty important announcement. This is NJCW. Now, then, you're probably asking yourself, well, this is not how a regular car commercial goes. Usually there's, like, they show something from the show. Well, we have a small little thing for you, so check it out. I bet you did, because in that video there was a subliminal message pretty much telling you, hey, guess what, you have to like NJCW. And now you do, and now you're my puppet, and now you're going to go subscribe to the channel. Because why? Because you're my
Dan and Cammy there. Limo pulled up here. Oh yeah! Yeah, he's here tonight! Haru Glory has just arrived here on Excel 60! And knowing what transpired at Ground Zero last Friday night, it's just about to hit the fan! Oh man! This night's only gonna get more intense by the hour, by the minute. But let's go back to Ground Zero here. Reiko Hinomoto had a battle with Diane the Giant, Ino Yamanaka's insurance policy, and Reiko did everything that she could by tackling through the barricade to putting her through a table, resulting in a counter victory. But I'll tell you this now, Reiko is now the official number one contender for that Women's Glamor X Championship, and I think this time around Reiko is ready to take that title off of the Natural. Reiko Hinomoto showing that she is one of the best talents all around the world today. And speaking of that, if you did not see Ground Zero last Friday night, it was announced that worldly renowned wrestling superstar Jury Sonata, that's right, Jury Sonata from SCA, Sports Entertainment Alternative, ran by Mr. Joseph Matos, Jury Sonata is officially coming to Anime Championship Wrestling for the Excel brand, and more specifically, more for the Glamor X division. And I'm telling this right now, like I said at Ground Zero, I'm going to say here tonight, this signing right here of Jerry Sanada is a game changer. If anyone has watched Jerry Sanada and her work, everyone understands what she brings to the table and how she can bring the atmosphere, the glamorous division, couldn't necessarily be looking for to take it to the next level. Jerry Sanada is coming very soon. And also this week, as a matter of fact, myself, Excel General Manager Dr. Smith, Joseph Mathos from SCA and BWF, and Jerry Sanada herself will be all in Sacramento for a press conference with Jerry Sanada as she will officially sign on the dotted line her ACW contract, and that full conference, or at least parts of it, will be posted on this very exact ACW YouTube channel this week. So make sure you look out and stay tuned for the press conference of Jerry Sanada. Time for some Glamor X action here as Reiko Hinomoto and Kami are going to square off here. Two ladies that are no strangers towards each other. That do know each other very well. Look at this here. Kami now, nice Irish whip here, fakes it. And there's a sidewalk. I thought she was going to go for a backbreaker. Change course. Kami. Oh, Reiko countered that calf kick attempt into a tilt roll backbreaker. Here comes Reiko. Kind of stopped and slowed down a little bit to think twice here. Reiko, Irish with Kami here. Reiko, look at this. Airplane heads to takedown by Reiko right on the middle of the ring. There's just a different feel from Reiko these past couple of weeks ever since she returned a couple weeks back on Excel. She feels the need that she could have beat Eno at ACW Fusion for that title had it not been for the debut of Diane. Now that Diane's taken out of the picture, now Reiko feels like she can take down Eno and finally win the Glamor X Championship that she's been looking to do so for a long time. And Kami with a nice calf kick to rebound. Speaking of Kami, that was a weird exchange that she had with Danny Beaky backstage just a few minutes ago. And I honestly don't know what angle Kami is going for as it relates to Dan. I mean, Dan and Asuka have been close friends for a while. They have been close friends for years, actually. But it feels like Cammy's trying to turn it into a Tekken Street Fighter thing, and I don't think it should be that way. I don't see the angle there, and I'm sure Dan doesn't see it that way either. But who knows? And Cammy with a nice back body toss, taking down Reiko. Yeah, Asuka's not even here tonight. She's still recovering from a match against Eno. She gave everything on the line to try to win that Glamor X title and did not get the job done. Not really her fault because that's Eno and her tactics, but that's what happened. Here's an Irish whip. And Reiko counters with a nice head scissors takedown onto Kami. Kami blocks a punch. Front face lock grapple. Knee to the midsection by Reiko. Kick to the midsection. Kami blocks that punch. Swats it off. And both ladies are back in stalemate, grappling with the collar and tie. Front face lock by Kami. Knee to the midsection once again. Reiko targeting Cammy's midsection quite a lot in this match. Now Kami now in the corner. And oh man, big boot. Didn't see it coming. Reiko once again going for the airplane. Henson's takedown. Boom, down goes Kami. It's never a dull moment when these two go at it. I can tell you that. And Kami punching the lower back there. Kami now, back suplex. Almost folded Reiko in half there. Covered by Kami. One, two, and a shoulder up from Reiko. Gotta wonder if you're the Glamor X champion, Eno. I mean, you got a lot of targets going on your back right now. Got Reiko Hinomoto, the number one contender. You've got the impending debut of Jerry Sanada in the very near future. You've got others like Kami, Samus, and Asuka. You've got really like a wild card in Revy. We will talk about later in this broadcast and what she will have to be doing next week, but Glamor X division is shaping up to be one of those divisions that you cannot miss here in ACW. It's like none other kind of female division you've seen on CAW, so there you go. Cammy now dragging Reiko, trying to drag her back to the ring here. Cammy will toss Reiko right back in the ring as we're at 8 here by the ref's count. So Cammy now finds herself back in the ring. Here's the cover. 1, 2, kick out by Reiko. Now Reiko, wrist lock onto Cammy. Side headlock. Oh, punch right to the face. Irish whip to the corner. Kick back. Arm twisted. Kick to the midsection. Punch to the arm. That's the kind of tactical fighter that Cammy's always been throughout her entire life. No surprise to see her influence and display that here tonight against Reiko. Doesn't mind going bat for bat, elbow to elbow with anybody, I'll tell you that. Now Cammy up top with Reiko on the top turnbuckle. The most overused move in all of CAW. The superplex off the top turnbuckle. 1, 2, shoulder up by Reiko. One of these days I'm going to take a shot every time a superstar does a superplex off the top turnbuckle. Probably be incoherent throughout the rest of commentary. Look at this. Takes down Reiko. That's Greco-Roman takedown. That's Cammy. Overconfident that she has this match in the bag and it's only a matter of time. Has Reiko up here. Big sidewalk slam. Takes down the Zero Fighter. Now Cammy now. No! Reiko kicks Cammy back with her leg. Big overhead lariat takes down Cammy. Now Reiko trying to find her footing here. Big knife edge chop. No. Kick blocked it. Oh, nice sweep from behind by Cammy. Now Cammy on the apron here. Up on top here, Cammy. Wow, nice missile drop kick onto Reiko. Could this do it here? Cover. 1, 2. Oh, and a shoulder up last second. Kick to the midsection. Here's the Irish whip. Punch to the face right there. Reiko, Cammy kicks her back. Cammy with the front face lock. Knee to the midsection onto Cammy once again. I wonder how long can Cammy's midsection still be in this match. Reiko has been targeting it very consistently in this matchup. Now Reiko Irish flips Cammy to the ropes here. And a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker takes down the Street Fighter. Reiko starting to get back her confidence here. The crowd here enjoying every second of it. Reiko from behind. Back suplex, bridge pin, cover. 1, 2, and a shoulder up from Cammy. That was very quick response there from Cammy. Cammy trying to come back with strikes here onto Reiko. Kick to the midsection onto Reiko. Front face lock. Knee to the midsection onto Cammy once again. My goodness. How is Cammy still able to breathe at this point with those strikes to the midsection here? Another backbreaker. And Reiko hyped up here as much as the crowd here tonight. Pushes Reiko back here. Oh wait, roll up. 1, 2. And Cammy kicks out. It is never a dull match. Never a dull moment with these two going at it. Trying to prove who's the better between the two. As Reiko's up top here. Reiko calling out for Cammy here. Reiko up top. Drop kick. Connects. Right to Cammy. I have never seen Reiko this determined since the Glamor X division started. Another strike to the midsection here. And a belly to back takes down Cammy. And I think Reiko's revving up to finish this match once and for all. No, Cammy pushes Reiko back. Reiko ducks from behind. Twists Cammy around. Rolls up Cammy. Cover. 1, 2. No, Cammy gets out of it. Oh, wait a minute. Cammy able to roll up herself. 1, 2. Oh, my. Look at the core with Reiko Hinomoto. Rolls it up with a counter. Cover. 1, 2. Cammy gets out of it. My goodness. Reiko side headlock. Look at this. Oh, no. She's got it set up. Sunrise suplex. Connects. Onto Cammy. Drags it in the middle of the ring. Could this do it? 1, 2. It's over. Reiko gets the 3. Reiko is victorious on Excel 60 against Cammy. Oh my goodness! It is never, I promise you, never a dull moment with Reiko Hinomoto and Kinnikuman battle here tonight. But this is the most I have ever seen Reiko determined to become Glamor X champion. And if I was Ino Yamanaka, I'd be preparing myself for a fight whenever Reiko challenges for that title once again. Because I think Reiko Hinomoto, I think she's for real this time. I think Reiko Hinomoto can get the job done. Crowd here enjoying that match. Wait a minute. Mano! Ino Yamanaka from behind. The Glamor X champion with a belt shot from behind onto Reiko. And what that tells me is that's desperation. That is a sign of fear and desperation from a champion thinking her time as champion is coming to an end. Oh, man. Need help from Reiko here. Oh, man. There's Haru. He doesn't look happy at all. Oh, man. he think he is? You're gonna have to deal with Ginji Amano and the Get Backers. And there he is! Ginji Amano in the flesh! And I can't wait to hear what he has to say about this whole situation from Ground Zero. Oh my god. Now I'm really gonna buy that game too, but still. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Ginji. Getting some hints here. Wait a minute. Ginji Amano. And there he is! Bombito's back in the building! Team Starfox not too happy! And the Get Banners are rushing to the ring here! Team Starfox getting the hell out of here! Running their tails! Hiding back to dodge, whatever what you want to call it, they're running! And look at this, Woody and Davis, the Little Fighters, on stage here! The Tag Team Tournament is gonna heat up very, very soon! Oh my goodness! Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you back to Excel 59 2 weeks ago. Samus versus the Masked Lady, Samus got the win, finally to take that down, but the Masked Woman continued her assault after the match here. And then when the Masked Lady was forced to reveal her identity, it was none other than Revy from Black Lagoon. All this time that was terrorizing Samus. But we can tell you next week on Excel 61, we will have an exclusive microphone interview with Revy detailing her situation, her reasons as to why she was attacking Samus all this time, and much, much more. Revy's exclusive microphone interview next week here on ACW Excel. And I cannot wait for what she has to say, why she did what she did, why she assaulted Samus, and everything in between. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our main event of the evening. Who's back? None other than Hiei. Hiei has returned to ACW. The last time you saw Hiei was at Victory with that whole debacle. Many can credit Hiei as the reason why the Reign of Hell for the Akuma as Excel Champion is a reality more so than a nightmare these days. It's Hiei that tried challenging the Excel Championship when Aang held it, didn't get the job done, attacked Aang afterwards. And Akuma fit in his Excel Robustic briefcase and then rest is history. So now he will be going one-on-one against Cloud Strife, still television champion. As him and Joe Higashi put on a stellar performance for that title last week, as you look at the still images. These images don't do it justice, folks. You have to go watch it on the Mega Events YouTube channel. Joe Higashi and Cloud Strife put on a clinic because they wanted to know which one was television champion and television champion material. And at the end of the day, Cloud Strife defeated Joe Higashi with that moonsault. But it was afterwards when Cloud Strife retained the title was afterwards, Joe Higashi accepting Cloud Strife's handshake. Very uncharacteristic of Joe Higashi, but maybe Joe Higashi, maybe him himself, maybe he has a good heart after all. Who knows? But it was great sportsmanship between those two. This tournament was better than who. Here we go. Bell rings. Both men grapple here, and here we go. Hiei, again, has not been seen since ACW Victory. A lot of people asking where the hell he's been. What has he been up to? I really don't know. And honestly, do you really want to find out? I really don't think so. Nonetheless, Hiei Irish from here ducks over. And cross got counter to the running bulldog. Drop kicks TA down. Clothesline TA down. And it's going to be very interesting because Cloud Strife has been wrestling very consistently compared to Hiei. So Cloud Strife will have that edge over Hiei going into this match. But that's not to necessarily say to count out Hiei, because Hiei is a very good talent despite me not being the biggest fan of this history here in ACW. He has just taken Cloud outside here. Both men are on the outside here. Big knee strike to the face. Like he wants to break Cloud Strife's nose with his knee. Relax, relax, relax. This Hiei elbow to the face onto Cloud Strife. Hiei on top of the apron here. Cloud Strife, no. Big forearm to the face. Hiei to the top rope. Drop kick. Didn't get all of that onto Cloud. The Cloud is dazed. Cloud ducks under. Cloud from behind, no, Hiei strikes from behind. Turns Cloud around here. Hiei with an Irish whip. And look at this. Oh, takes down Cloud. Those strikes there that very simple but was effective. Snapmare onto Cloud. Oh, fist drop. I'm just getting word from my headset right now as Hiei goes for the cover. No break by Cloud. Getting word through my headset that after this matchup, Haru Glory will make his way down to this ring and will call out Akuma. I am hearing that he's going to call out Akuma after this match. So, oh yeah, you might want to stay tuned for that. Hopefully we get to the bottom of what went down at Ground Zero. I hope so. Hiei, nice stalling vertical suplex onto Cloud. Behind you, Hiei, dropkicks Cloud. Counters with a power slam. An Irish whip. Oh my goodness. Now Cloud, no, he blocked. Oh, there's a forearm right there. Crowd obviously not the biggest EA fans here. I'm with them, so. Plus some VA there from behind. Waist lock, turn into a wrist lock there. And a flapjack face first onto Cloud. Now look at this, Hiei gonna go to work on the leg of Cloud Strife here. Cloud Strife's gonna be very busy these next couple of days, I'm telling you. He's gotta team up with Kinnikuman. Oh, that spinning wheel kick sends Cloud over the top rope. Hiei from the ropes, a side moonsault onto Cloud. Shades of Ultimo Dragon there, with great precision and air there, Hiei is in control. As I was trying to say here, Cloud Strife will be teaming up with Kinnikuman to take on Vega and Nightwing of NJCW for that NJCW ACW Super Show on Sunday, August 16th, Fighting Spirit Taikutsu. Cannot miss that show. It will be posted on NJCW's YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe to them as soon as possible, because that is the only way you're going to be able to watch that. So do so immediately as Cloud Strife comes back with a nice drop kick onto Hiei. And Hiei counters like that with a nice overhead arm drag. And a nice spinning back suplex. Seems like Hiei with the little ring rust he has is making up for it by controlling the pace, so that way Cloud Strife can wrestle Hiei's own type of match. Akasha trying to come back. But kick to the midsection. Irish whip to the corner. McCloud around here. Oh boy. Oh man! Sends Cloud right to the post and a knee to the face. Now he had control, clearly control. Look at those strikes onto Cloud. He with a quick cover. One, two, and a little shoulder up. I can only imagine that if Hiei does somehow win this match, he could be in contention for the television title. Nice overhead lariat there. I mean, Hiei has still, here's the cover, one, two, shoulder up. Hiei has still not been able to win a singles title here in ACW since 2007. Same would have went for Cloud, but he proved the naysayers wrong at Fusion by winning the television title for the first time in his career. And you think about it, Cloud Strife and Hiei, they're both ACW Turbo alumni. So it's not like they don't know each other. Cloud Strife took down Hiei there, but that was a little bit of an awkward landing there. But it was still effective as now Cloud, a nice spinning back suplex. Hiei blocks the drop kick, elbow right to the back. Cloud pushes Hiei back here. Cloud Strife. Irish to the corner. Cloud Strife has Hiei up here. Kicks back Cloud. Hiei's up top. Crossbody has the cover. One, two. On a kick out. Great matchup here tonight between Hiei and Cloud. It's been great action all around here tonight for Excel. Fallout from round zero. The next mega event for Excel. High voltage coming very soon. Probably not very soon, but more so in a month's time, or more than a month's time. It'll be the final XL Mega event before ACW in general is on the road to Animania 4 on December 18th of this year at Sun Life Stadium in Miami, Florida. Yes, ACW will be taking their talents to South Beach. Next Cloud Strife. Oh no, Hiei! Caught Cloud in midair. Counters with a backbreaker. That back's been worked on this entire match. The cover one, two, and the television champion with a shoulder up. Now Cloud trying to come back here, but Hiei again finds a counter for every offense Cloud is trying to come up with. Moonsault connects. He's got the cover. One, two. No! Wow, that was very, very close there. Now Hiei was trying to go for an armbar there, but it was too close to the ropes there. It's Hiei. Oh boy. Elbow to the knee. Cloud Strife is trying to come back here. Look at this crossbody. There he got it! Got Hiei there. And Cloud Strife starting to feel the adrenaline come back through his body. Cloud Strife, overhead neck breaker. Cloud Strife needs to keep Hiei guessing here. Because it seems like the more times Cloud Strife tries the offense, Hiei somehow comes back. Cloud Strife getting back his confidence back through the crowd here tonight. Oh my goodness! And Cloud with another crossbody off the ropes here. And Hiei still trying to get up here, but Cloud Strife is clearly in control here. Cloud from the ropes again, it's the back kick! Takes down Hiei. Cloud Strife's up top. And there's a moonsault! No, Hiei rolled back! Hiei rolled back! Cloud's back up. Oh boy. Third eye? No, Cloud counters it. Good eye there from Cloud. Final Fantasy, no. Hiei, Russian leg sweep. Cloud pushes Hiei back. Cloud has him. Snap DDT, takes down Hiei. Cloud's gonna go up top again. Cloud Strife, moonsault connects. He's got the cover. One, two. No, and Hiei kicked out. I thought that was a three count there. Kick blocked. Oh, spins it back to another kick regardless. Cloud Strife just needs to close in, and he's got this match won. Final Fantasy. He encounters into a Russian leg sweep. Cloud Strife elbow to the midsection there. Oh, Hiei, elbow to the gut. Hiei, kick to the gut again. Hiei's got it locked in. He's got it. Third eye. He got the third eye. One, two. No. Cloud Strife somehow, someway was able to get out of it. Third eye attempt once again. Cloud Strife rolls out of it. Cloud Strife still up here. Hiei goes down. Hiei's back up. Cloud Strife has him up here. Will he go for it here? Will he nail it? Final Fantasy. He got it. He caught Hiei with the Final Fantasy! Oh my goodness! The cover! One! Two! It's over! Cloud Strife defeats Hiei! I tell you what! If there was an award for Most Improved Wrestler of 2015, I think I'm looking at him right now! Because Cloud Strife has been putting on clinics for these past couple of weeks. And it continues here as Cloud Strife still is representing as the television champion. Oh my goodness. EA returned only to suffer a loss regardless. Wait a minute. Oh gosh, it's music here. I see him walking down to the ring here. There's Joe Higashi. The microphone at hand. I'm interested to see what's this all about. Let's see the whole Joe Higashi braggadocious in here. Let's hear what he has to say. I'm gonna hear. Did Joe Higashi just thank somebody? Wow. Who is this man? Whoa! This is absolutely shocking here, folks. Challenge has been made. There you have it. It's been made. The rematch of the television title at High Voltage. Oh, man. So we are getting Higashi Strife 2 for the television title at High Voltage in September. If it's anything like their encounter at Ground Zero, we're in for one hell of a match once again come September. The handshake has been made once again. A sign of respect from Joe Higashi. What the hell? What the hell was that? I should have damn well known. I apologize for my gullibility, but damn Joe Higashi for attacking Cloud Strife. He fooled us all. What a bastard that Joe Higashi is.
Getting your
ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Excel 60, and the night is not over yet, not by a long shot. Well, there he is, Haru Glory is in the building here tonight, and he wants answers. And a night that for him should have been all about redemption, beating Edward Elric at Ground Zero, has turned into worry and anger for the whereabouts of his friend Aang after what Akuma did to Aang after that hellacious Hell in a Cell match at Ground Zero. Haru Glory and Edward Elric went to war. A great, outstanding match between these two. The best that Excel has to offer, arguably, as Haru and Elric gave everything their all. It was intense, it was personal. And at the end of the night, Haru Glory was able to nail the Grave of Destiny and become victorious over the Full Metal Alchemist, bloodied and all. Here we go, we're going to hear from Haru Glory right now. And Akuma is being called out here by Haru Glory. Haru Glory not wasting any time. He wants Akuma's ass out here, right? Oh, well, that's not Akuma. There's going to even be a bigger headache for Haru Glory. That's the music of the Full Metal Alchemist Edward Elric. Wow. There he is. Edward Elric acting like a sore loser during this time of need right now. What the hell does Edward Elric want? He lost. He lost that ground zero. Is he really going to do this? Is he really going to do this right now? What in the hell is Edward Elric doing? It's not about him. Hold on, wait a minute. Holy shit. Son of a bitch. Wow, that is one creepy little bastard. Wait a minute. Well, here we go. Already did call him out. Where is he? Does that mean? And what in the hell is going on here? What is this? Where the hell did he go? So he didn't make that laugh? Who was he fooling? Even Elric and Haru are puzzled here. What in the blue hell? Wait a minute, what is this? What is going on here? Wait a minute! Who's that on top of the stage? Oh my god. That... Oh. That's the blue spirit! What in the hell is going on here?